Okay, I want to go to Mark in Houston.
No, oh, Mark hung up?
Yeah, Mark was apparently asking, is religion dead? Is it dying out? And I was just going to say, listen to the last call.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you think?
So who else do we have?
Jessica in Florida?
Yes, hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. My grandfather died at 94 years young, and he was a very liberal Methodist, a longtime member, 50 years. And I planned the service, and the pastor at the church wanted to read some scripture. Well, I handed him something my grandfather wrote, something like a scripture. He wrote something he left for his family memoirs. Meister Eckhart, I believe. Are you guys familiar with him?
No.
I'm not.
Uh-uh.
Meister Eckhart? Okay. And when I handed it to him, he refused to read it, and he gave it back, saying it wasn't scripture because he was holding a Bible, literally. And I said it was scripture. It was something that my grandfather left. And it was basically like a food for thought about just respecting our religion, Buddhist, if you're Jewish, if you're Taoist, African, Christian, basically it's like one well, but one spiritual being, and he just would not read it. He would just refuse to read it. I guess this guy comes from like 1260. He was a theologian, philosopher, mystic, but I was so disappointed he would not read that. Well, my father-in-law got up there and read it. Thank goodness.
Okay.
Good.
Yeah, I mean, and actually that was one of the things I was going to ask before you said it, was I can definitely understand the pastor, depending on his beliefs, saying I cannot personally read this. But I do think, and I was hoping and glad to hear, that they did give the option for somebody who could in good conscience read the passage out. And I think that is the right solution. I think the pastor, it could be a violation of his own conscience to read such a thing, but he should at least give the person who wants it read the opportunity to present it.
Yeah, I mean, I've never been in the position of having to arrange a funeral before. But, I mean, you know, it feels to me like the funeral really is about respecting the wishes of the person having the funeral. And you know, this seems like just another example of the way that religions co-opt things and go out and tell people, oh, it's really not about the dead person. It's all about us.
Right.
Just like I go to a lot of weddings where they say, just remember that the wedding is really about your relationship with Jesus. And I feel like, well, screw you. It's about our relationship with each other.
I have to say, though, if you are hiring a pastor to do the service, he does have religious convictions potentially that would, you know, make him unable to, in good conscience, express certain things during the eulogy. And I think that has to be respected. But I also think that if somebody wants something read and he says, I personally cannot present this because it is too antithesis to my belief, they should have a time designated where the family members could get up and express more secular beliefs that he is more in line with. Especially, I think you were describing something that was kind of religiously open-minded about different religions. And I can see why certain people affiliated with certain religions might have a difficult time actually expressing that without feeling like they were violating their own religious conscience.
Well, my question was, first of all, I knew my grandfather's pastor, it was going to be another like Sunday service, and me and my family we have Buddhists, we have atheists, agnostic members in the family, and this guy, it just seemed like it was just going to be another Sunday service, and just we were not going to let that happen, I guess. But my question was, when the pastor gave me back and made the comment to me, well, this isn't scripture, but if my grandfather wrote something for the family, was he being truthful?
Well, I get, are you, it's, I mean, scripture it's, is like
according
usually.
According to him, scripture is the Bible.
Yeah, I would
so
think that
yeah.
he's talking about what's written in the Bible or whatever creeds that he adheres to as scripturally accurate, depending on the religion.
Okay. But generally.
Generally, I mean, if somebody writes something themselves, that's not considered scripture.
Okay, well, I guess that was my question.
Okay.
Okay, well, thank you so much.
All right, thank you.
For your time.
Thanks.
All right,
sure.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Oh,
you got one more?
I don't have that up. What
here
is
you
it?
Go.
Jason in Chicago?
Yeah, yeah.
Jason.
Are you there, Jason?
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hi.
Hey.
I'm a huge fan. I've watched hundreds of your clips. I'm an atheist. I just have a really quick question.
Sure.
So you guys get a lot of angry callers and sometimes, let's be honest, crazy callers.
We didn't get any today. That was pretty good.
Have you ever felt highly uncomfortable with the level of somebody's anger, or have you ever been threatened by anybody?
Yeah, but I just hang up on them.
I've never felt threatened by anyone, and I've gotten heated calls that were passionate, but I wouldn't call them angry.
Oh, okay.
I generally am. I like to tell people sometimes, because I think it's surprising to them, that some of my most uncomfortable experiences with regard to being affiliated with this show come when I get into contact with other atheists, not with theists. I'm far less threatened by theists.
I see that. Sometimes an atheist will call you guys and will, I can see you guys want to agree with him or her, but he or she is making it really difficult to agree.
Yeah,
with
I mean, you know, I've had angry people walk up to me in my capacity as a show host. I was at a convention once and I had this guy like storm up to me and like try to yell at me about how feminism is ruining the atheist movement. And I said, excuse me, I'm talking to this guy instead.
There you go.
There are people who are going to get pissed off at you for all kinds of reasons, but you know, you don't really have to engage with those people necessarily.
Correct. Yeah, I'm breaking down. Hey, Russell, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I accidentally hung up on that
line.
Okay.
Oh, we lost the caller.
Well, we lost that caller.